Board of Hearing Minnesotans first applied for a grant to have Thompson Hall listed on the National Register of Historic Places. This is the first step in the process of preserving a historic property. More recently, Thompson Hall was awarded a grant to study their building through an historic structures report to prepare for more detailed design and construction work. While historic buildings are intrinsically interesting, what makes them even more compelling is learning about the people whose lives and stories are connected to these historic places. Herman Fechtman is the chair of the Board of Trustees of Thompson Hall, and Herman will tell us more about his community's experience.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Thank you, Madam Chair, members of the committee, and Mr. Elliott. I appreciate the opportunity to discuss this matter. As stated, my name is Herman Fuchsman, and I am the president of the Board of Trustees of Charles Thompson Memorial Hall. We are a nonprofit organization run by deaf individuals. We are a deaf club in St. Paul, Minnesota. In 1916, Margaret Brooks Thompson donated Charles Thompson Memorial Hall to the deaf community of Minnesota, so we would have a free space to gather. The building, which is located on the corner of Marshall and Fairview, was given in memorial to Margaret's husband, Charles, both of whom were deaf and met at the Minnesota State Academy of the Deaf. It was the first deaf clubhouse in the United States. The building was designed by architect Olaf Hansen, who is widely regarded as the nation's first deaf architect, and was a close friend and former classmate of Charles Thompson. His design techniques accounted for good natural lighting and sight lines to enhance communication through visual sign language. The building continues to serve as a social hub for deaf individuals in the Twin Cities, and has played an important role in the growth of Minnesota's vibrant deaf community from Duluth to Faribault to St. Cloud and the like. Many organizations and social groups use this space. The thriving Minnesota deaf community can be attributed in large part to Thompson Hall and our deaf club. We celebrate, we grieve, plan, learn, organize, advocate, and socialize in this historic site. This building is showing its age and certainly needs repairs. It isn't accessible at this time. There's no elevator. The trustees and community would like to preserve this architectural gem and community treasure. In 2011, we applied for a legacy grant, and the experts have helped us, and they've been terrific throughout this process to build and receive this designation. Most recently, the Board of Trustees applied for and received a historical and cultural heritage grant and are in the process of getting bids from architectural firms for a historical structure report. They are also working with the nonprofit Deaf Equity to organize and get input from the community to ensure that accessibility and ramps, plumbing and heating systems are improved. We want to ensure that stories of Thompson Hall are shared, both architectural and cultural, with the public as a part of Minnesota history, and more importantly, preserve Thompson Hall as living history and a resource for future generations to appreciate. We invite you to visit us. We thank you for your time and the role you played in ensuring that these funds are made available to small, volunteer-based organizations like ours.
Thank you, Herman.